You guys all know the deal. We'll give it a minute and then we'll get started. Excuse me. What's going on, Russell? Well, I can't stop yawning. You know, it's funny. I do, not specifically about Corona, but I do this thing called My Points. I know there's other ones that are better, but I've had it forever, so I just keep with it. But, you know, you take surveys, you know, click link-throughs and stuff. It's like all the other sites. I do surveys through there. Couple have been COVID related. Hey, Liz. All right, let's get this thing started so I can get some. I got to catch up on my sleep. I've been up too late. For the last few nights, that's catching up with me. So tonight we got ourselves 2019 Star Wars Masterworks. Another blowout cards break. Based how I did in the random, since I took a spot, hopefully we'll pull 36 top autographs. There's my buddy Sebastian. Here to watch some Star Wars. Yeah, Sebastian, now that you're back watching, check back in on Monday, probably. I'll be doing a case of Stellar, the 2019 Stellar. Break number 4 is up. See how we do to start. There's one of the film cells and a blue of Ahsoka and Chewbacca. Not like you can really see anything, but hey, Trevor, I guess I don't need to show you that card. I have it right here on the side, just in case. But you were able to see it from the picture I sent you. Oh. All
don't even know why I'm doing this. I'm not going to keep these boxes. You know, I finally cleaned out most of the boxes that I had in. We got two blues. Oh, no, that's Heroes of the Rebellion. That's why. Heroes of the Rebellion, Admiral Akbar, a blue Finn. There's our base. And we got ourselves Dark Side Holofoil of Darth Maul. These are numbered out of 299. And Kelly Baber. Man, look at that signature. Thank God. Thank God they wrote their name out, too. I never in a million years would get that. Not a bad sketch. Gamorrean Guard, right? Up close. So, Sebastian, I would guess you're going pretty stir crazy up there. I'm guessing that all your clubs and stuff are all shut down, nowhere to go. Here's a green of Tarkin. Green, this is number 61 of 99. And base autograph of Christopher Sean as Kazuda. Jono? I don't know. I don't watch the animated shows at all. Yeah. I mean, that thing's a pig all day long. Matter of fact, didn't it squeal in Return of the Jedi? I gotta rewatch the movies. I haven't watched them in forever. Of course, plenty of movies I want to see that. And base. Heroes of the Rebellion. Captain Andor. Here's a blue of Jin. And here's a blue autograph, Mark Austin, number 99 of 99, last one in the run. There's a medallion in here. I could. Right, there were medallions in this, wasn't there? This box just felt heavy. Maybe we got one of those booklet cards. That'd be nice. Just when I picked up the box, it felt very lopsided, weight-wise. No, definitely not. That one, I think, feels a little heavier. Well, looking at the women of Star Wars, I didn't realize how many different Princess Leias there were. Base. Another Darth Maul. This one's a base version of the dark side. Blue is Rey. And And medallion number 14 of 50. R2-D2. It's purple. I forget if these fit in the thick saw sleeves or not. I don't remember. Not easily if they do. Nope, it fit. Oh, wow. That's what I need, George. You know, I didn't get a chance to respond back to you on Facebook, but with your Walking Dead break, you know how you had the one box that was short and autographed, but didn't that box have three relics, and one of them being an SP at least? Blue of Chirrut Imlay, green of Animated Count. Oh, you know, I'm sorry, that's a Heroes card. There's a base. And how do we do here? Katie Cartwheel, base autograph. So at least you got the SP relic in that box that was missing. I mean, I would take that over a scrub autograph. You know, how many, what was that? That was part two, right? So how many Gareths can you get? Heroes Holo Foil of Bees. They're numbered at a 299. Autograph. Base, and a blue of Luke. Young Luke. Autograph is a base of Matthew Wood. At least with Bob, on some of his cards, he put Tainted, which was okay. Kind of like Joe putting his claimed on his. Too. Here's a purple of the Jawas, 25 of 50. You know what on these bases I forgot and I knew. Hold on. There's another one down here. I put the defining moments right with the base cards. They're all the, these are the base versions. And then there's a holo foil, and that's another base. Mace Windu. Again. Numbered at $299, and our film cell, Admiral Piet. All right, so a decent sketch, but so far we're not going crazy here. I finally did my draft list. It's pretty basic, but I assign values to the different cards, you know, based on their rarity. I'm not going to get so crazy as, you know, when it's all this medallion, when it's all just a, you know, a bunch of tier two and base cards, you know. I'm just going to grab them. That's why there's, you'll see a row of numbers next to all the packs. I actually have, I mean, if you want, if you can post for me, Russell, in the break itself, but I can actually, so my next pack is pack 31. Nobody's picked that yet. I hope I'm not confusing anybody with that other list on the side. But if you could send a message to whoever's next in line, which is Mason, I would appreciate it. But I just did the spreadsheet, but I can't spend too much time. Okay. Space medallion. Dark side of Darth Sidious. The blue of Denarius. Is that his name? And this is a base medallion of a belt buckle. Thank you, Russell. Are you still watching, Liz? I had a question for you if you are. I'll have a general question for everybody. How are we all making out in our shelter in place? Hollow foil of a defining moment. Here's our film cell. Here's a regular defining moment. A green of Kit Fisto. And that's our base card. And film cell. I got Darth Vader at least. I don't know why I'm even showing these. It's not like you can really see much of anything. Your daughter is 6 years old? Am I remembering that correctly? I know when we were talking, you had said that she doesn't watch Clone Wars with you, but she'll watch Rebels. I actually have some Star Wars cards that are for Clone Wars. Do you think she would enjoy it if I mailed a package addressed to her so that way she could open them? Just wanted to ask your permission first. Blue of General Recan. Blues go here. Oh, wait a minute. I keep doing this every time. That is a Heroes card. Blue is Captain Rex. Base autograph. Mary Elizabeth McGlynn. They had put out a set of Clone Wars cards, maybe. Ooh, geez, I want to say 8-9 years ago now. If it isn't, I've got a damn near a master set of it here. Yeah, not a problem at all. Hello, Sandy Frank. And just because I'm not familiar with that username, who... Are you in this break? Base. There's a holofoil dark side of Darth Vader. That goes there. And defining moments. And we got ourselves a purple of Ray, 34 of 50. And we got a canvas, or is this a wood? I think it's a canvas. Numbered out of 25, 17 of 25, Mark Austin. I'll be honest with you, Jason, that doesn't help me, unfortunately. Mega Star. So, Sandy, you pulled, was that big, like the 20 autograph book? Let's see, where's our, here's our medallion. Oh, okay. Well, hopefully you can get in on one. And if you are, if like what Jason, okay, hopefully that luck there, you can bring that into some of our breaks. I feel like my luck in Star Wars is very limited. I hate to say it. Space. Down yet. Heroes of Han Solo. Green of Director Krennic. And base medallion of Padme with her belt buckle. Oh, well, congratulations on that. That's a nice... A nice hit. Unfortunately, I barely have enough time for my own breaks, so I don't get a chance to really watch others. I always like to say this in air quotes, but when I'm at work during the day, thank God I've got an office job and I get to do a lot of work while I'm at work. Defining moments, holofoil of Han Solo. Dark side, Darth Vader. We got ourselves an orange, 5 of 10 of Hondo. And, oh, this is nice. I mean, the person's not the greatest. But this is Christopher Sean. This is my first one I've ever pulled. 1 of 1 pen. Come on, focus for me. There we go. So that's cool. One of these pen relic autographs. I'm sort of with you, George, but, you know, when we opened up, was it Last Jedi? We had pulled that one, and I want to say, Trevor, you might have been the one that picked it, but we did pull a red autograph, but it was like a, just like a villager or somebody, and even though it was a 1 of 1, it went pretty low. But I'll take it. Defining moments, blue, Princess Leia. That's an Empire Strikes Back. Scott Lawrence, base autograph. I can tell you that I feel like in Star Wars, the very first Masterworks I remember doing very well with, and the 2016 High Tech, we did really well with. And then after that, it's been hit or miss. I would love to know. I was trying to remember, like, I know some of the pulls that I've had. Heroes of the Rebellion, Holofoil, Admiral Raddus, Defining Moments, a blue, a Queen Amidala, and Young Luke Film Cell. Excuse me one quick second. Are you saying you would have had off tomorrow anyway? All right. Be quiet, though, please. Sorry. I think, Jason, with more of the hobby cases of Game of Thrones, my personal opinion, I could do another one now, but I think I would actually wait a couple of weeks, only because the price is going to go down. Let's see. I don't feel a medallion in this one. So I think that if we wait it out a little bit, because, I mean, this is, season 8's okay. I like, you know, the inscriptions are neat. You know, it's something new. You know, relationships, quotables, parallels, they're all the same. The acetates are cool. I really like them. The image is a little tiny on them, but, you know, I'm blind. So, I just kind of chalk it up to that. A green of Val, a dark side holofoil of Seventh Sister, and Return of the Jedi Luke film cell. Oh, did you just get on, Darren? It's an animated character, but we did pull a pen autograph. You know, pen relic. Oh, maybe there's a medallion in there. That one feels heavy. I didn't notice it at first. But it's not thick. Maybe we got something different in this one. No, there's a medallion in there. Base. Heroes of Princess Leia, a blue of young Han Solo, and purple Luke 22 of 50. Yeah, Christopher Sean is the actor's name, or voice actor. That's the pen relic, which is kind of cool. They're a one of one. Yeah, I mean, luckily for me, I don't think so, Sandy. I got to go do these in order. Let's see. So, George, yours just went off the screen. I thought I responded. Obviously, I didn't. I think that combining with inflections, I think everybody's just, you know, set on season 8 right now for Game of Thrones, and I do think the hobby cases will go down in a little bit. You know, we just got to wait for the new car smell to wear away, and then we can go back to that. It'll, you know, drop down, not a ton, but I bet you it'll drop down $50, $75 a case. Defining Moments, purple of Jin. So our purples are good. We got Jin and Rey. And who'd we get? Charlotte Louise, base autograph. Yeah. The medallions, they remind me of something. I can't place what I'm thinking of, but what the medallion is of is so just random. there's a few breaks that I would love to just finally be done with. Like that, the Twin Peaks archive box. Because they sent me that box by accident, so I've been sitting on it for, hell, it's got to be 2 months now. Defining Moments. Dark Side. Blue of Lando. And Blue Autograph of Josh Brenner. Yeah, bass is definitely nice in Masterworks. Maybe the board game Clue. You know, it's like you got the candlestick or the pipe wrench. It's just completely off the wall. Now, Sandy, I do have to disagree with you. The lightsaber hilts were cool from Finest, but the, and I'm, again, I lose track of what's what, but one of the, this would have been probably 2 years ago now, so maybe even three. So I'm going to guess it was Force Awakens Series 2, maybe. One of them where the medallions were, the card was black and the medallion was like golden black. I remember those being really nice. Defining moments. Green of Newt Gunray. And hollow foil. And we got 12 of 50. Katie Sackhoff. And I think the absolute worst were not medallions, but when they did, actually two. They did the little patches of the ships. And they were kind of like rubbery. Those were the worst. And I had one of the ships looked like a cordless drill. Blue of Poe. Base. And Princess Leia film cell. I've always said this from the beginning. Yeah, that's true. That the rubber ones are all out of whack. I don't mind the medallions. I really don't. Sketch. That's a nice sketch. Dark Side of Kylo Ren. Blue of Animated Obi-Wan. And Patricio Carrasco, I think. Or is it Carassus? And this is it's a snowtrooper, right? Kind of like that kind of muted purpley color background. That's pretty cool. But in regards to the medallions, if they would just, I'd rather them say one hit per box and that the medallions are just an insert. Saying, counting that as an actual hit and saying, you know, two hits per box, I feel like that's just an insult. Base. Heroes of Lando, blue of Captain Andor, and we got ourselves a wood, 6 of 10. Billy D and Peter Mayhew duel. Way better than any animated duel. It's a real shame, you know, that Peter was still signing, you know, late into his declining health. And I like both of our sketches. I think they're both nice. Heroes, blue of Holdo, and this isn't bad. I mean, it's a shame for what these go for, I guess, because it's not what he's really known for, but a base of David Tennant. Let's see. And this, none of these really feel heavier, so maybe we got another sketch. I always wondered with certain characters, actors, I should say, that if you're a Star Trek fan, or excuse me, a Star Wars fan, and there's, you know, like Paul Reubens and Bobby Moynihan and David Tennant and George Takei, that do you know that they're more famous for other things? Defining moments. Blue Commander Cody. Yoda film cell. I always remember when we opened up, I'm trying to think if it was an Evolution, and I pulled a George Takei, and I was happy. I was George Takei. That's a great hit. And then I looked up what his Star Wars, because he's just a voice actor for an animated character. They're worth nothing. You know, I mean, obviously Paul Reubens and Bobby Moynihan aren't, you know, huge. Holofoil of Lando. Here's a sketch. Dark side, green IG-88, Rachel Brady. I'm going to go with, is that Poe? Ah, okay. I see it. Now that you say that. I don't remember him smiling too much when he was older in the movies. So I saw that kind of smirk. Defining moment, blue of Jango Fett, and Tova Feldshoe base autograph. Well, fingers crossed. Let's see. There's definitely a medallion in this box. You can just feel the weight. Or the booklet. I'll take it. The one thing about these boxes, because it's a flap, doesn't have the whatever you call a little piece that sticks inside the box. Sometimes it could be a pain to cut open. I'll go right to it. I love the framed autos. Yeah, it's just a medallion. Base, defining moment, heroes, green of Nienum. That's why if I had the balls to join in the Stellar Break, I would love that reproduction set because they're all framed. That thing weighs like 20 pounds, that reproduction set. All right, so it's a base, but at least this one makes the most sense out of all the medallions that we got so far. So it's Luke, and the medallion is a blast shield helmet in there. So there's a printing plate, then damned if I could feel it. They all feel the same to me. I would think a printing plate would be much lighter. Tell you what we'll do. We'll open up the last three. Everybody can take their bets. So we've got three packs. We did a medallion, so then we probably won't have a film cell, right? We'll have two autographs, or is it going to be two autographs and a film cell? Oh, film cell. The two autographs and a film cell, sketch autograph and a film cell. What do you think? And who do you think? I've got my terrible guesses, but only because I feel like we're not going to have I think we already, got our big hits. Space. Here's our autograph. Defining moments. Blue of Darth Maul. Blue autograph of Matt Lanter. Now, Jeremy Bullock. Let's see. I can't tell. The film cell is too close to a regular card. Base. Base. Defining moments. Blue of Kylo Ren. I'll make you guys wait on this last card. No giveaways. Got a gold heroes. The golds, I believe, are wood. 7 of 25. There's our autograph. Here's our regular heroes. Purple of Luke. Autograph, Myrna Velasco, base autograph. And to end on a good note, it's not an autograph though. 6 of 8. Forgot about these. Source material. Oh, come on. There we go. And this has a wrinkle in the middle. If it kind of looked like there was a little bit of a what do you call it? Wasn't piping, like it kind of showed like a light thing near the bottom. That's just a wrinkle in the fabric when they put it in there. All right, well, I'm very happy with this case. I think we did very well. Come on. Just got to get this to go in there. They need to make these cards fit better with supplies. I mean, there's only two sizes of soft sleeves. There's regular and thick. I don't think they make super thick. There we go. All right, so quick recap. We got three sketches. So we got Anakin from Rachel Brady. I thought it was a snow trooper, but somebody said flame trooper by Patricio Carrasco, or it's Carrasis, I don't remember. And a Gamorrean guard from Kelly Baber. It's a jumbo costume relic, 6 of 8. Blouse from Kira. Film cells are film cells. Most of the autographs, just go to the good ones. We got a base David Tennant. They're all pretty. Got a pen relic, 1 of 1, from Christopher Sean. And our dual wood, 6 of 10, of Billy D and Peter Mayhew. Sorry, I already have them in soft sleeves. You're getting a little bit of a glare. Everything else is pretty much standard. We didn't get any printing plates or like a great character of a parallel. Even, you know, we got an orange, but it was just Hondo. You know, our purples were actually halfway decent because we got Rey, Jin, and young Luke in the purples. So that was good. All right, so that was it. Thanks for watching, guys. Our next break's going to be Marvel Premiere. I think there's one payment left on that. I'll send out a reminder. Hopefully we'll do that on Saturday. Sunday is Easter, so I don't think I'm going to be able to break Stellar on Sunday. I think we're just about all paid up. There's only a couple strays. I think we're going to end up breaking that on Monday. And then next up after that would be Game of Thrones Season 8 Archive Box number 2. The cool thing about the Archive Box is now that some of them have been broken, we all know that all of the vulgar inscriptions they put in the Archive Boxes. So we're still trying to get ourselves a good one out of there. And we've got a bunch that we're filling. I just submitted the Star Trek inscriptions break right before I started this. So that should pop up soon and we can get filling on that. That should be really interesting on the base cards since there's approximately 2,000 cards in the base set. And if there's anything you want to see me break, send me a message here on Blowout or join the Facebook group, iFish 73 Non-Sport Group Breaks, because on there we're filling Rick and Morty Season 3 premium packs. We're more than halfway done. Hopefully we can get the last of the people in there so we guarantee a 10-pack box and get our final cut and hopefully that redemption. And I think that's about it otherwise. I'll get these scans done as soon as I can. I'll probably be up there by tomorrow. And I guess that's about it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you on the next break.